Please be seated. From the Presbyterian Church, one of the things that happens is everybody likes to sit in the back. So the walk of shame for those who are late is that so we'll all just giggle as they come to the front. Good afternoon. My name is Craig Sanders. I'm one of the pastors here at Grace Presbyterian Church in Las Vegas. We're so happy you're here. The family is overjoyed that you would come and honor the memory of Michaela Susan Brooks. Want you to know that there's also we're live streaming with that little phone right there. So if you're around that, you don't want to say anything that's going to get you in trouble. Because it'll pick you up. We're so glad that we could be here today. I'm going to start with a few sentences of scripture. Our help is in the name of the Lord, Psalm 124 says, who made heaven and earth. When we are baptized in Christ Jesus, we are baptized into his death, Romans 6 says. We are buried, therefore, with him and by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in his death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection. Jesus said in John 11, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me shall live even though they die. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. 1 Peter says, praise to the God, our Father, of our Lord Jesus Christ, whose great mercy gave us a new birth into a living hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. The inheritance to which we are born is one that nothing can destroy or spoil or wither. Blessed are those who mourn, Matthew says, for they shall be comforted. The 1 Thessalonians says, we believe that Jesus died and rose again. And so will be for those who have died in Christ. God will raise them to be with the Lord forever. Comfort one another with these words. Pray with me. Holy Spirit, the giver of life, comforter of those who sorrow, you is our sure confidence and our everlasting hope. Before you, we worship and adore, saying blessings and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving, honor, power, and strength be to our God forever and ever. God, who gave us birth, you are ever more ready to hear than we are to pray. You know our needs before we ask, and our ignorance in asking. Show us now your grace, that as we face the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity. Speak to us once more your solemn message of life and death. Help us to live as those who prepare to die, and when our days are here or ended, enable us to die as those who go forth to live, so that living or dying, our life may be in Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. There's two passages I want to read from the Old Testament that are hopeful. And the first is from Psalm 139. Lord, you have searched me and you know me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discernest my thoughts from afar. You search out my path and my lying down. you're acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, Lord, you know it altogether. You are before me and behind me. You lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high, I cannot attain it. Whither shall I go from your spirit, or whether shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand holds me. If I say, let only darkness cover me, and the light about me is night, even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is bright as day, for darkness is as light to you. This is Psalm 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all our iniquity, who heals all our diseases, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with steadfast love and mercy, who satisfies you with good as long as you live. Lord, works vindication and justice for all who are oppressed. He made known his ways to Moses, his acts to the people of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love. He will not always chide, nor will he keep his anger forever. He does not deal with us according to our sins. Isn't that good enough? Nor requite us according to our iniquities. For as heaven is high above the earth, so great is his steadfast love toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far does he remove our transgressions from us. As a father pities his children, so the Lord pities those who fear him. For he knows our frame. He remembers that we are his. Today we gather together to celebrate the night in the life of Michaela Susan Brooks. Susan passed away on August 1st, 2024, at the age of 73. She was the only daughter of Helen and Mike Neal, who moved to Vegas when Susan was in the sixth grade, where she would live until she went away to her college years at the University of Kentucky. I see Kentucky Blue there, right? She graduated from Valley High School, and during that time, she would meet Dwight Brooks right here in the youth program at First Presbyterian Church. And I've noticed a lot of people walk in here and say, oh, I know somebody got married here. Oh, I've been here before. I was in the youth group. I was there. So I want you to know, you're all welcome. Please come. Visit us. Following high school, she would attend the University of Kentucky. Susan and Dwight reunited by Lobe Wilding, and there they had their first child, Dwight Jr. She received her bachelor's degree from the University of Kentucky in nursing. After Dwight joined the Air Force, they moved to Fort Worth, amongst other places in Texas, where I came here from 2 years ago. But they had their second child, Rebecca. There, Susan worked in the neonatal intensive care unit. When Dwight left the military, Susan and Dwight, their family, back to Las Vegas. Susan received advanced degrees in pediatrics, labor, and delivery nursing. While she was working, And all that was while she was working too. Family did life together, and they hosted exchange students. I saw that they made a point of that in her obituary. That was wonderful, a great thing. Susan was active in the Junior League in Las Vegas, where she was a leader holding several officer positions. She earned multiple master's degrees, which she led to advanced practice nursing degree from Syracuse University in 1996. And Dwight came in and he gave me her resume. I could read this thing. You'd be here, 2 hours from now. If you really want to see it, I'll have it at the reception. It is pretty impressive. This degree thesis became the inspiration for a clinic on wheels, a mobile clinic in a bus, which led to helping Kids Clinic. It was a nonprofit organization that operated for 18 years, functioning as a full-service medical clinic. In retirement, Susan, alongside Dwight, and this makes me tired, she was so busy and doing so many things. Functioning as a full-service medical clinic. For retirement years, Susan, alongside Dwight, kept helping others in their community. They worked with FEMA, administering COVID vaccines during the recent pandemic. Susan loved to travel, enjoyed the theater, and most importantly, infants and children. Yahoo. That's a great calling in life, isn't it? Susan Brooks joined the Church Triumphant and along with her son Dwight, who preceded her in death. She will be greatly missed by her loving husband, Dr. Dwight Brooks, her daughter Rebecca Heller, son-in-law Darren Heller, daughter-in-law Heather Brooks, and her deeply loved grandchildren. Dwight the third, or Trey, I guess that would be, right? Peyton, Darren the second, Allison, an extended family, and you, her close friends. She's an inspiration to her family and friends for her career in pediatric medicine and her life purpose of changing the world one child at a time. Her obituary in the Review Journal ends, "The world is a little better because she was important in the life of a child." Thank you to the family for letting me help in telling her story, which they will keep on telling through honoring her life and the way they live their lives. I want you to join us afterward, but we're going to watch a video after I pray. With some great pictures and some beautiful music that you loved. So let us pray. Lord, we thank you for life. We thank you for loving us so much that you gave us a purpose in living. Remind us that you heal the brokenhearted, bind up the wounds of the afflicted. Strengthen us, calm our troubled spirits at our loss, dispel our doubts and fears. In Christ rising from the dead, you conquered death and opened the gates of everlasting life. Renew our trust in you. By the power of your love, we shall one day be brought together again. Let our sister, Susan, grant this as we pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Love around me.
The New Testament speaks to us. None of us lives to himself and none of us dies to himself. We live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Romans 14. Gospel of John gives us hope. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it was not so, I would have told you, but I go to prepare a place for you. When I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and I will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. You know the way where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. These things I've spoken to you while I am still with you. The Counselor of the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you, not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Jesus said to his disciples, "You now therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again, and your heart will rejoice, and your joy no one will take from you." He said, "Go now and have sorrow." Human beings do not belong to one another. We are God's children. We belong to God. It's by sheer grace that we are together for a time and for a little while. We receive God's gift of another person in our lives with thanksgiving. But we realize that this person is a gift. Susan Brooks was a gift. One of God's own tiny children. And for a time she gave, and God gave Susan to the world in order that two human beings might have a child. And that child might be part of a family. That her extended family might know what it means to be an aunt or a cousin or a sister-in-law or a grandmother. Later, that a man might have a loving wife and two children. And that those children would have a devoted mother. And for many of you, Susan taught you about what it means to have a friend, a wonderful co-worker, fellow follower of Christ. And for all of you, Susan taught you more fully the greatness of the love of God. God loved the world so much that he gave us Susan. That was really good of God. But now Susan is gone. And the world won't see her again. God received her back. And that is painful. And there's no way under heaven to minimize that pain. Jesus said, "Go down, therefore, and have sorrow." We are not sorrow because God is cruel or unjust. The world did nothing to deserve Susan. God gave her as a gift to us freely. Not because we deserved her, but because he loved us. We're not sorrowing because God is unjust. We are sorrowing because Susan is gone. We know the pain and the heartbreak all too well. We've experienced this before. And we will never be the same, and that's right, too. We can't be the same ever again. We're here to say goodbye to one of God's children. Jesus said, "You know, therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again, and your heart will rejoice, and your joy no one will take from you." He said, when you pray, say, "Father." God, our Father, loves Susan. She belongs to him. She always has. He created her for a time. He gave her to the world. And now he has received her back. And now we know emptiness. That's the way it is with all human beings. We're here today reluctantly to offer Susan back to God. In so doing, we are offering ourselves. We're here to trust God, to love him, and to realize how much he loves us too. We're here to say goodbye to Susan, one of God's tiny children. Today we must let go of her hand. In so doing, give it over to the arms of her heavenly Father. We cannot hang. We must let her go, for God has hold of her hand, and he will never let it go. Amen? Pray with me. Lord, it's a special thing to be at life's transitions. For people who are left behind, for people who feel emptiness and longing. Lord, for Dwight and for Rebecca, it has been a long walk. Hard walk. Watch their mom and Dwight's wife slowly fade. Lord, we are so glad that she's in your presence now. The pain is gone. Confusion is gone. And our memories are full. Lord, we thank you. We pray with you now the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. You, Lord, are only mortal, the creator and maker of all things. We are mortal. Form of the earth, and to the earth we return. This you ordained when you created us, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant, all your saints, where there is neither pain nor sorrow nor sighing, but everlasting life. Holy God, by your creative power, you gave us the gift of life, and in your redeeming love, you have given us new life in Christ. We commend Susan to your merciful keeping. The faith of Christ our Lord, who died and rose again to save us, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. The blessing is go in peace. And may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, be the great shepherd of the sheep. By the blood of the eternal covenant, equip you with every good work that you may do God's will, working in you what is pleasing in God's sight. Through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. I'm going to take these two out of here. Yeah?
Oh,
you had what?
The soul.
Oh. I'm sorry. This is a good place to be.
Yes. You know, before I sing my song, I just want to share something with all of you. What a great legacy we are celebrating today. And that in this community, the impact that she left here is so great. And when all of us leave here today, we are part of a great, great legacy. Those of us who have been to Brooke's home and had food and shared laughter, shared tears, we are part of Susan's great legacy, and also the Brooks family, who have given back to this community in such a great way. I stand here as a part of that legacy too. One who has walked into a home and felt loved. So, I was going to sing a song that Rebecca requested, and I'm unable to do that, but I'm going to sing another song. The song I was going to sing is, You'll Never Walk Alone. And we all know the lyrics to that song. Because we are not alone in the darkest times of our lives. We are not alone. This song that I am going to sing is the song Precious Lord. And thank you to the family and to the pastor and to everyone for having me here this evening.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, help me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, now lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call, take my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, now lead me home.
You know, Presbyterians are pretty staid. I tell my church, when we clap in church, it's not because we are like saying good job. We're saying I want some of that. I want to get up and I want to make some noise because I agree with that. Thank you so much. We're going to go, and you're going to meet everybody over there, all right? So as I lead them out, then please join us for this great time together.